Hi guys, welcome to Fishing with Phil. Still bunged up, so you're gonna have to excuse that. So where we're gonna go today? We are going to go to St. John's. We're gonna start at 6, oh, 5, short day, long day. 1 day equals 3 hours, random, dynamic, tackle box 1. I'll be taking my 9-foot fishing rods, because I ain't got anything better at the minute. I'll be taking 2 silt rigs, because I know primarily St. John's, especially where I fish, is silt. 1 gravel and 1 weed. And the baits, I'll be taking a 15mm boilie, blood worm, sweet corn, and corda dumbbell. Let's go have Luke. So, normally I'd come in on this right second from bottom point, and I'd start fishing probably these pegs here, but I'm going to come in at this one purely just to see if there's any shows. Got any fat little shite, get a move on. Right, no, there's one more peg. Can we weasel our way through to it without no, have to walk around here. Oh yeah, these are the pegs I wanted. Oh, hang on. Normally, I would fish any of them 4 pegs there. Let me just, any of them 4 pegs there, straight directly across from me, from the Portaloo 4 along. I normally catch quite a bit, but what I want to do today, just have a look, see where the fish is showing. They're showing in quite close. Oh, you see they're showing on the other side now. Maybe I should just go over there and start with it. Oh, look, there's another one there. Alright, I'll tell you what we'll do. There's a couple of shows around here, just in front of me. Let's go for this. One in there. Just make sure it's silt all the way up. Yeah, right. Let's claim this peg. We're not silt all the way up. Doobie doop doop doop. And what I do to get my tight range is I point the pointer at the last one that you cast, and it lowers it slightly to the right, just like that. Let's get another one in. That was boily boily, and I'm going to stick this one on dumbbell. All 3 in. Right, just bear with us 1 second, we're just going to let them settle and then we'll start spotting. Right, so we got all 3 rods in there. Let's see if we can drop some spot mix over it. All we're going to do is just come into that corner there. Cast out. Don't worry about where I'm hitting at the minute. As long as we cast it out, can pull it in. As soon as I get it to about the right there, like that, clip it. 29 yards. That might spring back. No. That's alright. Drop it in and wait for the cloud. Oh. Let's just get that drop down. Let's go for number three. Come on. There we go. Double catch. Come on. I could do with this one coming in now. Come on. Come on. So we've got one on Boily, which is rod one, which is still out there. And this current one that I'm pulling in is on dumbbell, 18mm dumbbell. Come on. There we go. Reel her up. That's to be quick, so I need to get. Oh, I've got to say, number two is going on one as well. Oh, that's a shame. Catfish. Alright, let's just get that in. Let's bring in number one next. Come on. Hopefully, I can get these two in. I think this, with how this is being, this might be a catfish also. He's holding me out. But there doesn't seem to be too much pressure behind it. So it's got me out at about 21 yards at the minute, 20 yards. Come on. It should tire in a second. We should get it in. Get onto that other one. Whilst that noise is still happening, it means that the other one's still on, so I don't mind that at all. There we go. Laugh if this was a catfish as well. No, nice common there. 16 pound common. Let's get number two, come on. Let me have number two. And there we go, fish still on. I need to try and get him back around from that side. So I'm going to put it up quite aggressively. This is now 50 yards out. Let's try and pull him back in a little bit. Six. Alright, he's coming. There we go. Let's get some slack on. I can't really see where it's going because we're on this corner. Oh, he's tied out anyway. Come on, man. Oh no. Thank you. When you're getting snagged. And there's another catfish. 22 pound catfish. Lovely. So catfish. Catfish are on the boilies then. Yeah. And the carp is on the dumbbell. So let's drop it to dumbbell. I don't mind catching catfish, but this is rod number two, I think. Don't mind. Catching catfish, but I'd rather go for the carp at the minute. As you've seen, I've just pulled three straight out of here. One rocket of spod. Let's do some more spodding if I get a chance. I'm not going to, because number two is going to go. It's going, it's going, it's going, it's going. Fish on. There we go. Ooh. Alright, I think this might be a bit of a big boogie here. Booger. Yeah, this is going to be a heavy booger, I think. I think this is going to be maybe in its 20s. At least. Possibly up to like sort of mid 20s, 22, 23 pounds. There goes number three. Ease it in nice and slowly. We're down to 17 yards. There we go. Come on. Get in the net. Let's have a look, see what we've got. Oh, look at that beautiful mirror. What were we at? 23. Now let's go straight to rod 3. There goes rod number 1. So that's 3L again. Oh, this feels a bit of a heavy bugger as well. Don't you dare go around that corner. Right, number one's well and truly hooked on. I'm gonna have to start just fishing with one rod, I think, at this rate. Get stressful catching fish all the time. Come on. Come on. Let's put it up to 42 resistance on the drag. There we go. Now we're getting some slacking. Come on. In you come. Oh, that's gorgeous. Gorgeous coming. 18 pound common. Come on now, let's get rod number one. Start wheeling around. And we've got fish on. So, two casts, two fish on each rod. And we've been going for 36 minutes. In game time. Come on. There we go. Come on. Come on. Beauty. Another gorgeous common. 22 pound common. Right, so what we're going to do is we're going to have a little quick look at what rig I'm using. So obviously you know the rod and reel I'm using. It's just the beginner rod and reel. I'm using the Corda 12 touchdown line. The Corda IQD Rig 6. Remember, the lower the number, the bigger the hook size. And that's why I'm getting sort of like mid doubles and upwards on the catches. And we're using the Active 8 boilie, the 15mm boilie. So let's go for another cast. I'm going to see if I can go in the same area. Remember, I've only put one spot out. And the first spot was to find the distance. The second spot was a proper baiting spot. So it's not like I've hammered it with regards to feeding the swim. Let's see if we can get up a bit. Sorry for drinking whilst I'm recording. I say this all the time. Just full cold at the minute. Let's see if I can get a spod in. Every time I seem to go for the spod, it never works. Put on the fridge. Oh, let's ease off the drag a little bit. Number one's going to go. Or is it number two? There's some movement on the other two. I don't know if it is going to go. I thought it was. I'm liking using the larger hooks because I'm not getting so much roach or bream or tench, so it's keeping it nice and carpy. There's another one just gone. Let's capture this one in the net. Should be a carp, nice size. Oh, gorgeous mirror, £15. Let's get rod number two. Now, if number one goes whilst I'm bringing this one in, I don't know what to say. It's just like hitting the sweet spot. Goes back to my video, hopefully. There we go, look, it's going to go. Jesus. There we go. And it's away. Hopefully you'll have seen my video where I explain about tight fishing. If you haven't, please do so. Come on. In you come. Yeah, give me any slacks. I need you out quickly so I can get onto rod one. Alright, so this one's going straight into the net. Lovely common there, £16 common. And fish on. Nan cast, nan fish. Jesus, excuse me. I think this might be a bit of a heavy one, actually. I can't increase my drag, and I dare reduce it too much. Just reduce it a little bit, take some of that tension off. It's still staying out at 32 yards. Right, here we go, 31. For some of you guys who wondered why I was just maybe holding it still without working the rod, if the tension's right up and it's not far from going on to breaking, just keep it where it is. As long as you keep your mouse button pressed, so that if any slack does come about, you're going to take it in. And you're not going to lose the fish. Let's see what we've got. Look at that beauty. Gorgeous common there, £27 common. How amazing is that? Absolutely gorgeous. Right, let's go again. So what rod are we on? We're on rod number one. So rod number one wants to be up there. Let's drop it down. Rod number two. Fish is just shown directly next to where rod one is. I'm going to try and get this as close in as I can. Look at that, beautiful. It's perfect, it's exactly where I wanted it. Hopefully. Just look at that. That's stunning. Shall I go for the spod again? Shall we try and spod? Let's try and spod. We only need to put a little bit of a spod out because it will go quite the distance and we're clipped anyway. jumps back a little bit. Alright, the weather's come down quite a bit now. We don't mind. We're just gonna stick with it for a little bit more. So let's have this bit settle over the top. Get this in quick before one goes. Is it gonna go? And it's gone. Oh. Come on. Going up to this will be my 10th fish. Number 3 is about to go. Jesus. And there's number 2. 3 fish on. Right, remember 1, 3, 2. I'll always pick up in the order at the bite. Come on. You know you're getting tired. Come on. Do yourself a favour, we'll be over quicker. There we go. There's one in the net. It's a nice mirror. Let's go for 3. Hopefully it's going to stay on. Alright, I'm going to get number 3 in. Let's crank it up a little bit. Sit about 44. Come on, you need to come in. You don't need to stay out there. Come on. This is the way. Alright, it's going to tire soon. Usually about here it will start to tire. Oh, let's just give it a little bit of slack. There we go. I think it's going to be a little bit smaller, maybe 14, 15. 16, not far off. And let's bring in number 2. Hopefully I haven't lost it. Look at that fish on. So this will be fish number 12. And all I've done is cast my rods into a tight area where there was a handful of shows. Spotted twice. And I'm just reeling them in. I mean, I'll be honest with you. In game time, it's only 8 o'clock. I've got plenty of time left. I could sit here all day and just keep pulling them out. That another gorgeous mirror, 15 pound mirror. So guys, I'm going to call it a day there. I wouldn't normally, but because I've rather smashed pulling the fish in, I'm just going to call it a day. Pack up, go home, chill out. I only came on really to farm some tackle points, and I've managed to get that done, so I'm going to just go for a little run around here in the rain, like an idiot. Look at that, we've got squatters again. Damn squatters, peasant people. So that's my little game for today on St. John's Lake. I shall catch you in the future. Take care guys, and keep fishing.